you remember the story in the Bible when the prophet Samuel was sent by God to anoint one of Jesse's sons to be the new king of Israel? And so when Samuel saw the first son, because Jesse brought all 70 sons into the room, and when the prophet Samuel saw the first son, Eliab, he thought this was the one. So he jumped up to anoint him, but the Lord intervened and said, "No, Samuel, it's not him." And then the word of the Lord came to him, and God said to him, he said, "Samuel, do not look at his appearance or his physical stature, because I, the Lord, I see the heart. Now you see the countenance of another human being. You can see my face." And so we judge a person by what we see, but we can't see the heart. We can only see the outside, but God can see the heart. The Lord says, "For I, the Lord, sees the heart of man." And so he was not the one to be. Then they brought Abinadab. It was not him. Shammah, all 70 sons. And the Lord said, "No, not one of them." And then they brought David. And the Lord said, "That's him. Anoint him. He is to be the new king, because God sees the heart." Now the word of God teaches us that when we look into the Bible, when we read the word of God, then the Lord reveals our heart to us. Can I show you your heart? Have you ever seen your own heart? Now let's go on this venture and I show you the heart of man. Amen? Have you seen the human heart? You know what we read in the Bible? God sees the heart of man. And here we can see the heart of man. In this instance, we can see there's a spiritual battle for the human heart. This represents darkness and this represents light. So the human heart is a divided heart. And there's a battle for this heart, the heart of man. Even in your own life, there's a battle. Why do we say that? Look at this human heart. The heart is full of things that you see inside, animals, pictures. And there's things outside the heart, and there's things inside the heart. So, when we look at this human being, we can see when we look at his face, and this represents our heart, your heart and my heart, we can see that he's perplexed. He has a battle. You can see that there's a problem and he's having a hard time. Now, there's things outside the heart. The dove represents the Holy Spirit. And the Spirit of God is outside the heart of man. Why? Because of all these things that's in the human heart. And the angel represents the Word of God, because the word for angel is also messenger. So the Word of God that brings the message, the Spirit of God, and the flames represent the love of God. And the love of God is absent in the heart of man. Although God loves him, we can see here that also here down here we have the flames representing the blood of Jesus, the Son of God. And the blood of Jesus has not been applied to the heart. And God can see everything. You remember that when we saw in 1 Samuel chapter 16, God says, "I can see the heart of man." And look what God sees in this heart. God sees what is in this man's heart. He sees what is in your heart. And what does he see? He sees pride. Because this is a very beautiful bird. It's a peacock. And the peacock represents pride in the human heart. Don't tell me what I must do with my own life. Here we have the dog, and we use the symbol of the dog for sexual immorality, because the dog will have intercourse with another dog in public. So this speaks of all different kinds of sexual immorality in the human heart and in the human mind. And this is a pig, a very dirty animal. And when it gets to mud, it will jump into the mud and it will eat all kinds of dirty things. You can clean the pig, but when you release it, it will jump back in the mud. So this speaks of all dirty things in the human heart. And this is a tortoise, speaks of laziness and also speaks of spiritual witchcraft. And so here we have the battle of who will reign in the human heart. And now we see we have a leopard. And in the leopard, we have an animal that's a very fast moving animal, one of the fastest moving animals on earth. But also, it speaks of hatred or temper, and it will run down its prey. It will kill its prey, because this speaks of bloodthirst. And human beings will kill for what they want. They will harm somebody for what they want. That's what is in the human heart. When we look at the snake, we realize that the snake speaks of a few things. It speaks of deceit. It speaks of lies. And also it speaks of things that is wrong that we can find in our own life where we will not be open with people. We will, in our own heart, we will deceive people. And that is the spirit of the devil, by lying to people and to deceive people. Here we have a frog. Now this frog is very interesting. In Congo, in the rainforest, you will find the frog sitting close to an ant hill, and it will eat all the ants that come out. And so it will not move away, and it will grow and grow, and it will never stop. So we speak of the things of the world. The human heart always wants more things in its heart. And the conscience, the star, speak of the human heart that is darkened by sin. And so the human heart is full of things that does not please God. And here we have the devil, and he says, I belong in this heart. Now, this does not end there. Looking at the second chart, we realize that this man has a battle. Can you see when you look into his eyes that the one eye is closed? He's not praying. He's spiritually asleep. And the other eye is looking around to the things of the world. So this man, he is spiritually not on the place where he should be. Because God said, I can see what is in his heart. Look at his conscience. It's again darkened by sin. So it is again becoming dark. And here we see the cross and we wonder, but why is the cross here? Well, he heard something about Christianity, but he never knew who Jesus really is. And you can see there's still pride. You can see that the dagger is there, speaking of cutting, hurting you. You know, it speaks of words, because the Bible says that words can cut into your heart. Like a knife, like a dagger. People say things to you and it really hurts you very deeply. And here we can see the lies are still there. And the deceit, deceiving, it is still there. So here we see the battle of the human heart that is a divided heart. Going on, we now see the human heart in a different way, because this is actually what it is. We can see that the works of the flesh, if you do not confess it before the Lord, then the devil will eventually take over and demons will take over this heart. And now you can see that there's no place for the Holy Spirit. There's no place for the Word of God. And now the evil that has taken over the heart, this heart is now totally lost. And the devil, he says, this is my heart. It belongs now to me. And this person don't even know, but he's totally lost. And of course, this will have influence on his life, because when he die, he will be lost. Because he said no to the Word of God. He said no to Jesus. He never accepted Jesus into his life. Now, if that is what you do, you will pay the price, a very dear price, because death has come. This is the end. And hell is waiting for this lost sinner. This is the end of the sinner. But this is not the end of the story. Looking here, we realize that God has done something. What has God done? He has sent his son, Jesus Christ. And he died for you and me on the cross. Jesus was crucified. Jesus died for us. He was buried. And on the third day, he rose from the dead. But the night of his betrayal, you can see what has taken place. Not only did Jesus die for us on the cross, but the evening before that, they put the crown of thorns on Jesus. And they whipped Jesus. And Judas betrayed him for 30 pieces of silver. They gambled for his clothes. In the evening, they come. And they took Jesus away. Even Peter denied the Lord. But Jesus, the Son of God, died for me and you on the cross. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, who gave his life for me and you. And he took our sins on the cross. He died for you and me. He became sin so that we can become righteousness of God. Now, if I turn the chart over, you can see your heart in a different way. Your heart and my heart is clearly shown here as, but something has happened. What has happened? Well, Hebrews 9 verse 27 says, it is appointed unto man once to die, and after that, the judgment. So he hears the message, because I've sinned, I'm going to die. But the Word of God is like a two-edged sword, and it cuts into his life. So he heard the Word of God. He hears, but Jesus loves me. Jesus died for me. Jesus gave his life for me. And now he's confessing his sin. So this is the heart convinced of sin. Look at his face. The sorrow. Lord, forgive me for what I've done. I'm so sorry, Lord. And now once you start confessing your sin, the Holy Spirit brings enlightenment. And now the Holy Spirit starts witnessing into your life and into his life. And you can see what's happening when the light of God comes. The blood of Jesus follows. And now the blood of Jesus is cleansing his heart. And his conscience begins to lit up. God can see what is happening. He heard the message. He accepted the word of God. And now all evil is fleeing his heart. And this is not the end of the story. Look what's happening here. It's new life. It's been born again. Because now he accepted the word of God. Now you can see the word of God, the Bible, has entered his life. Look here. The messenger, the word, his feet is now in the heart. In other words, if you accept the word of God, then the word of God penetrates your heart. It has happened to him. And you can see he has peace with God. And now the Holy Spirit is inside. The light has come. His conscience is clear. God's eye is at rest. The blood of Jesus has cleansed his heart. And the love of God is poured out in his heart. This is the life of a newborn believer that accepted Jesus Christ as his personal Savior. And now look at this. The heart has changed. All the animals is gone. Look what has happened here. The fruit of the Holy Spirit, love, joy, peace, everything has changed. The heart has become a temple of God. And the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit is now in the heart. And the conscience is clear. The joy of the Lord is there. This is your life as a newborn Christian. Oh yes, there is still a spiritual battle. That will always be there. But God will give us the victory as we see here. This is a victorious life of a Christian. From the joy of the Lord and the blood of Jesus cleansing his heart, he lives a straight life. Look at this. From the joy of the Lord through the blood of Jesus, a clean conscience, he loves Jesus and he lives a life of self-denial. Jesus says, if you follow me, you must take up your cross and follow me. And this man builds his whole life on the foundation of the word of God. And you can see as an open purse, he does not keep his money for himself. He shares it. And also he worships the Lord. Oh yes, there is a spiritual battle, Ephesians chapter 6. But God give us the great victory. And he shares his food, his bread and his fish. And yes, this is the victorious life. Of course there's temptations. And you can see what has changed here. This was a dog, now it's a goat. That was a leopard, now it's a donkey. So the devil will come with all his temptations, but the blood of Jesus will protect me and you and your heart. And this is not the end, because look at this. Here we see what the word of God says. When we die, the angels of the Lord take us into glory to receive the crown of glory. This man, he's just died. His spirit has left his body and is on his way to glory. This is the homegoing of the believer. Now he died in peace, knowing that Jesus is his Savior. And it's such a huge difference, because there's only two ways to die. I mean, let me remind you to the picture that I've shown you just now. I'd like to show it to you again, because it means that me and you, we will have to make a choice in life. And the choice what we have to do is, are we going to die like this? Or are we going to die like this? To die like this means to be lost, to be without Jesus. But to die and to go to heaven means I've accepted Jesus. So my question to you is, are you going to die like this? Or are you going to die in peace like this man died? How did he die? He died knowing his name is in the book of life. He has eternal life. He received Jesus Christ. This we know that he's going to heaven. What is the difference between the first and the second picture? Jesus Christ. If you accept Jesus Christ as the Son of God into your life, he can become your Savior, even today. And I would like to invite you to pray with me and to give your life to Jesus Christ, knowing that when you die, you will go to heaven and receive the crown of glory and be forever with God and your name in the book of life. So I would invite you to pray with me the sinner's prayer, to accept Jesus Christ as your personal Savior. Can we pray together? You have seen the heart of man. You have seen your own heart. You've seen the sinfulness of our human hearts. And you realize that you need Jesus. You need forgiveness. You need eternal life. That your name will be written in the book of life. This is your opportunity. Right now, this very moment, to give your life to Jesus Christ. He died for you because he loved you. Can we pray together? Will you pray with me? Let's pray in the name of Jesus. Father, thank you that you've sent Jesus Christ, your Son. Thank you that Jesus came to die on a cross and gave his life. Jesus, I've seen my own sinfulness. I realize what I've done. I've break your heart, Lord. Please forgive me, Lord, my sins. I confess my sins. Your eye have seen my sins. I can't hide it from you, Lord. I ask your forgiveness. Father, in Jesus' name, please, Lord, forgive me. Jesus, I accept you as my personal Savior, the one that gave his life. Thank you that you give your Holy Spirit. Let your Holy Spirit come and live in my heart. Let the light come and live in my heart. Eternal life come into my heart so that I can be saved, be your child. I accept you, Jesus, as the Son of God, the one who died on the cross as my Savior. Thank you, Lord, that you forgive me, that you accept me today as I am. I come with my sinfulness, but I know you will accept me, Lord. Thank you for your forgiveness. Thank you that you loved me so much that today you've shared your word with me. And now, Lord, thank you for saving me, writing my name in the book of life. Thank you that your Holy Spirit now lives in my heart, that I can be a new creature and belong to you. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' precious name. Amen. God bless you. Congratulations, you have accepted Jesus Christ, the Son of God, as the Savior of your life. God bless you. Amen.